Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Sonali. Welcome to my channel if y'all are new. Today I'm going to be unboxing the 11-inch iPad Pro, so let's get straight into it. I just picked this up from my hub lockers at my apartment and I'm so excited to unbox this. I purchased both of these on Best Buy's website because Apple said it was gonna get here like mid-early June and I just couldn't wait that long, so I tried to see what other options I had and Best Buy was able to ship within a week, so I went for that one. So let's get into it. I'm gonna start with the Apple Pencil and then we're gonna get into the iPad Pro. This is the second generation Apple Pencil. As you can see, it has a flat side, so it feels more like a pencil when you're actually writing. It also has a matte finish, which feels really nice and very sleek. Overall, the design is very simplistic. They took away the end cap, which the first Apple Pencil actually has, and it's so annoying because it just falls off. So that's why I had to buy this little Amazon thingy to make sure I don't lose this end cap because I was really worried about that. As you can see, the second generation Apple Pencil definitely looks a lot better in my opinion at least. Now it is time to unbox my 11-inch iPad Pro. It is truly so beautiful and I like don't want to mess it up. It's just perfect. I'm in love with this design. I love the flat edges. I just feel like it's easier to hold for some reason and I'm really excited about this. It looks beautiful. Let's take a look at this camera. I actually have the iPhone XS Max still, so it's definitely not one of the newer phones and I don't have access to the wide angle camera, which this iPad actually does, so I'm excited to use that. I will definitely be using it for like a couple of home pictures and more pictures inside my house. I don't know if I would really take this iPad out and shoot outdoors, but I won't say never because you never know what could happen. The back is gorgeous too. I'm noticing these three buttons and I'm not sure what that's for. Oh, I already got fingerprints on my screen, so sad, but it was beautiful to look out for that, you know, couple of seconds. So let's turn it on and we'll go ahead and set it up. Oh my God, I forgot that there's no home button. That's so weird. While that's booting up, I just wanted to quickly show you this is the seventh generation iPad. This is what I had before this. This one unfortunately died on me. I don't know how to fix it. There was some minor cracks because I did drop it, but I really don't think that had anything to do with like it dying on me because it's been so long since the cracks. But I did have the rose gold and I don't think I saw the rose gold option for this iPad, which kind of sucked. I honestly just wish there were more options. Like I really like the space gray. I'm glad I went with that instead of the silver, but I wish they would come out with like a nude color or like a taupe color. I think that would be so cool. Like not a rose gold, but like more of a muted rose gold. I would literally buy that in a heartbeat, but let's go ahead and set up my iPad. Let's create a passcode. I hate long passcodes, so I'm just gonna stick to the 4-digit one. I'm gonna try to restore from an iCloud backup because I want pretty much everything that I had on my last iPad on this one, so I'm gonna do that off camera as well. Like I previously stated, the iPad Pencil does connect to this iPad, like actually connect with a magnet, so that's what it looks like, and it only connects to this right side. While it is restoring, we'll just go ahead and unbox everything else. So this is the charger and the cord. It is the USB-C cord, and I'm just wondering what cord is it gonna be next, because I swear they always switch their dang cords. It's so annoying. My iPad has been restored. We just have to wait till all these apps download. Now that I have my iPad all set up, I wanted to talk about it a little bit more in depth after a couple of days of using it. So my first impressions, we can go over them again. I probably said them in the unboxing, but the first thing is that it's really lightweight, or it just feels like that. I'm not really sure if the weight is the same as my iPad 7th generation. Maybe it's just the style that makes it feel just so much more sleek and lightweight, if that makes sense. Speaking of the design, I really like the straight edges. For some reason, I feel like it's easier to hold for me. I personally think the 11 inch is the perfect size for me. I feel like anything bigger would be a little bit overwhelming. I've been using the Apple Pencil for the past few days, and I found out that you couldn't swipe to go home, which is really annoying because you have to like literally use your finger and switch from your Apple Pencil to your finger. So that's just like one inconvenience that I found with this iPad. But I mean, I guess the last iPad that I did have the home button. Either way, I guess I did have to use my fingers unless I like wanted to like press in the home button with my Apple Pencil. But I don't know, I feel like that's kind of weird. I wish they would make a gesture for the Apple Pencil to go home. Maybe I just need to research it, but that's just something I found. Another thing I found, which I thought was so cool, is that if you take your Apple Pencil and just start drawing when your screen is locked, it will bring up the Notes app and you can just draw or write like down notes that you need. I think that's really cool for all those creatives out there that just have ideas pop into their mind like every 5 seconds and just need to write it down before it like literally disappears out of their mind. So that is definitely an exciting feature. If you're one of those people that are on the market for an iPad just to draw and procreate, because I feel like there are so many people that are wanting iPads just for that reason, especially during quarantine, and no hate, no shade, because that is literally one of the main uses of my iPad. But I definitely don't think you need to spend as much money to get this iPad Pro. I think you'll be fine using the iPad 7th generation or the first generation Apple Pencil or just an iPad that doesn't cost this much. The one thing I will say, this Apple Pencil allows you to shade when you like put the Apple Pencil on its side, if that makes sense. So that could be really helpful in Procreate to any illustrators or designers out there. If you guys didn't know, they did come out with a new keyboard that goes with the new iPads, and this keyboard actually has the trackpad. In the past, it was just a keyboard without like any mouse, so you would have to use your fingers. So it could act as a laptop replacement if you're really stretching it that far. But personally for me, like I need somewhere to plug my hard drive in, or like I do a lot of video editing, photo editing and stuff like that. So even if I got a lot of storage on this iPad, I really don't think it would like be sustainable for me. I just think of an iPad as an addition, really. I'll be completely honest with you guys, my uses for this iPad are not like extremely important. They were to watch YouTube, watch Netflix, especially while I'm editing on my laptop. And that sounds really dumb because you're probably like, why can't you just turn on your TV? But there's just something about it, like having it really close to you and like being able to like see that well, because I don't know, my eyes are bad. Another reason that I needed to get this iPad when my other iPad died on me is because I do make animations in Procreate. I don't draw anything really that extreme, but it is helpful for when you want to make brush strokes and like make it very customizable to put under text, or even just like doodle on a thumbnail to make it really stand out. I also designed my whole photography website using Procreate. I would literally just like doodle whatever I wanted to, export it as a PNG, then go to my laptop, put it in Photoshop and make it how I exactly wanted it. Then I hired a coder off of Fiverr to actually do all the back end stuff. So he pretty much saw exactly what I wanted on my Photoshop PDFs. So he knew like where to place everything, because I'm not good at coding, but I feel like I know exactly what I want when it comes to like design and stuff like that. So that was really helpful. I'll actually link down below my photography website if you guys are interested in checking that out. The last way that I can think of right now that I'll be using this iPad is to read my notes while filming. I feel like this is just so much better than an iPhone because the iPhone is way too small, so I'm just gonna be like squinting at it the whole time. And it's also even better than a laptop because that thing is like so chunky, and if I were to sit it on my knee or something like that, you would definitely be able to see it. So it's nice to have this iPad with my Google Docs on it, because that's where like I write and plan out all my things that I want to say. It's not really that I'm like scripting my videos, but just to make sure I have everything that I want to say to you guys. That wraps up this video. Let me know if you guys have purchased this new iPad or are wanting to purchase it. And if you guys want to see more iPad videos, like maybe what's on my iPad or how I use my iPad on an everyday basis, let me know in the comments down below. And I will see y'all in my next video. Bye!